It's one thing to run the New York City Marathon. It's another to do it blind. In 2017, Simon Wheatcroft did just that, becoming the first blind person to run the marathon unaided, thanks to the Wayband, a device that helps you navigate entirely through vibrations on the skin. Though the Wayband made marathon history, the tech behind the Wayband was actually developed for a much different sport.
This all started for me because I wanted to build a suit that would allow me to download Kung Fu using vibration. So that was my foray into the world of haptics.
From that idea sprung WearWorks, a haptic design company run by Keith and co-founder Kevin. Inspired by the experiences of their blind friend and now company advisor, Marcus Engel, Kevin and Keith committed to using their haptic technology backgrounds to help the blind and visually impaired communities.
I wanted to create something with a new functionality that was innovative. How do I really change lives of somebody using a product, using design?
They figured out how to do just that with the Wayband. So now the question remains, can they raise the capital to bring the product to market?
The road has been ridiculously challenging, but I think from my point of view, the road of life is always challenging. That's the entrepreneurial journey. It's about autonomy, it's about independence, it's about freedom, but freedom isn't free.
You just started your dream business. How much profit would you need to pay your basic living expenses like rent and ramen? This is a show on the economics of entrepreneurship and founders turning their dreams into reality. This is Ramen Profitable.
When we were first doing this, we didn't really know a lot about what we were doing. So I got this box of stuff. This was BS0. This was the very, very first prototype that we built. This is BS10. This is one of our early versions of the Wayband. This is actually one of the Waybands that we used to run the marathon with. We had to put a bigger motor on so that you could feel it clearly. So yeah, so we were just doing what we could with what we had. All the technology that we spent building in here ended up being the technology that got compressed and made it into here.
Years of prototyping later, WearWorks finally has a model ready for launch, with the first units going to awesome people like Erskine.
Hey man, how's it going?
Hey, how you doing?
Keith, man, pleasure to meet you.
I'm Erskine, nice to meet you, man. How's everything?
It's going fantastic, man.
So the Wayband is a wristband that gently guides you to your end destination using only vibrating cues without the need for any visuals or audio. When you're going in the right way, you feel absolutely no vibration at all. And when you start to veer off, you'll get a tiny vibration. And that vibration will get stronger the longer you are.
Oh, nice, okay. So long as you have no vibration, we're good. That means we're straight. Mm-hmm. Every little bit helps.
Let's go.
Getting the Wayband to this point was no simple task. Though WearWorks faced many obstacles during development, their largest challenge came back in 2017 after they received a $250,000 NSF grant that they spent in just 6 months. As Keith and Kevin learned the hard way, to make your product cheap, you first have to make it expensive.
The National Science Foundation grant was the biggest grant that we've ever received. $250,000 did not last a long time, that's for sure. We paid our interns, we hired a software team, we hired a guy from MIT, and he was doing all the PCBs for our prototypes. That grant got us to the first phase. We have a product now. But once the money ran out in the grant, we were going through the drought.
We went almost 18 months with no funding at all, like not a single dime into the company.
No money. No security, no healthcare, nothing. We were a lot more stressed out, a lot more angry at each other, and we were scared as well. It was like a roller coaster of just constant failures and mistakes.
The temptation to quit is super real. You're doing something that you don't know is possible. You're walking into a venture that basically has a 90% failure rate guaranteed as part of the process. I could be making $200,000 a year right now, but I'm choosing to make $2,000 a month instead, all for the hope that maybe one day this will turn into something that is huge.
To make ends meet, Kevin and Keith taught and consulted while they continued refining the Wayband. Despite the lack of funding, they refused to give up.
The reason I never really quit was because when I looked at all the other things that I could do, they were just different ways of doing what I'm already doing right now.
The silver lining of the fear and of the drought is we always get back to the core, the value of why we're doing this, and are we willing to sacrifice everything we have for it? And obviously, it's the reason why we're still doing it, you know, 6 years in. Now we're looking at what are the assets we have built, what do we need to do now, and how are we gonna get profitable, and how are we gonna get interest of further investments right now?
So we started building relationships with blind, visually impaired organizations. We did speaking engagements. We were talking to people who were in the space, working with other people in the haptics world to see what life does our device have outside of the blind and visually impaired community and outside of navigation. And then all of a sudden, things shifted. We got an investment, and that investor's reputation brought in a lot of other people who we didn't even know were on the table at the moment. So things just kind of started piling in. So we basically like went 18 months with no funding and then raised $500,000 in the middle of a pandemic.
So their networking and tenacity paid off. And now their fundraising is back on track.
We're currently raising a $1 million round and we have 49% of that closed. That's going to get us our first 5,000 units and get us to break even by the end of the year.
WearWorks' plan is to begin manufacturing their first units in June and then launch in October. After launch, they plan to market the device through pilot programs with the Olympics, the Paralympics, and blind and visually impaired organizations.
What do you enjoy about it?
This could take me to the park by myself. It gives me the freedom to be free.
Money always comes and goes, so you gotta have a purpose and one that you can stick to for years and years to come. It's a really tough industry if you also choose technology. Get a good co-founder, build up a good team, and have a purpose in an impactful market that you really can make a change in.
This is really about freedom. It's about autonomy, it's about independence. That's the entrepreneurial journey. But finally, that's also exactly what Wayband is about. It's about giving people freedom, autonomy, and independence. And one of the things that I've kind of learned personally in life is that the easiest way to get the thing that you want is to give it to others.